From building cities on Mars to the extinction of chocolate, these are 9 events that will happen before 2050. Number 9. Colonization of Mars. No, we're not talking about an upcoming sci-fi blockbuster. The colonization of Mars is a real possibility in the foreseeable future. Conditions on the surface of Mars are closer to the conditions on Earth in terms of temperature and sunlight than on any other planet or moon. However, the surface is not hospitable to humans or most known life forms due to the radiation, extremely low air pressure, and an atmosphere with only 0.1% oxygen. This means that human survival on Mars would require living in artificial environments with complex life support measures. While NASA has said that the idea of making the surface of Mars habitable in the near future is not realistic, billionaire SpaceX owner Elon Musk disagrees. Musk is currently funding and developing a series of Mars-bound cargo flights set to launch as early as 2022, followed by the first crewed flight to Mars in 2024. During the first phase, the goal will be to launch several spacecrafts to transport and assemble a methane and oxygen propellant plant and build up a base in preparation for an expanded surface presence. It's all with an eye towards the ultimate goal of getting humans to Mars by the 2030s. According to Musk, it could take anywhere between 40 and 100 years to ship enough people over to Mars to populate a city with 1 million inhabitants. So what do you say? Would you want to be one of the first people to leave Earth and move to Mars? Let us know in the comment section below. Number 8. Nuclear fusion. In nuclear physics, nuclear fusion is a reaction in which two or more atomic nuclei are combined to form one or more different atomic nuclei and subatomic particles, neutrons, or protons. Fusion was accomplished in 1951 with the Greenhouse Item nuclear test, while nuclear fusion on a large scale in an explosion was first carried out on November 1, 1952 in the Ivy Mike hydrogen bomb test. One of the biggest challenges of fusion energy has been sustaining the right amount of heat required to produce meaningful amounts of fusion power from plasma, and no one has yet managed to build a commercial fusion reactor. However, a team of researchers from MTI has reported that with adequate federal funding, a prototype nuclear fusion reactor could be tested within 30 to 40 years. Over the last few years, scientists at MIT and around the world have made significant progress toward developing ways to break up the tidal waves of heated plasma and reduce the escape of heat from charged gas. China has also made advances in planning for an experimental fusion power station called China Fusion Engineering Test Reactor that would start in 2020, while the European Union and Japan are currently building a powerful machine designed to harness the energy of fusion called JT-60SA. In other words, we are close to achieving a system of unlimited clear energy that would finally solve all global warming issues. Before we move on with our list, go ahead and subscribe to our channel so you don't miss out on any of our upcoming videos. Number 7. Interstellar Exploration. Until recently, interstellar travel was nothing more than a theoretical possibility. However, the exploration of other star systems may become reality sooner than you think. Russian entrepreneur and physicist Yuri Milner is currently funding the development of a fleet of light sail spacecraft named Starship that will be capable of making the journey to Alpha Centauri star system 4.37 light-years away. A flyby mission has been proposed to Proxima Centauri b, an Earth-sized exoplanet in the habitable zone of its host star, Proxima Centauri, in the Alpha Centauri system. At a speed between 15% and 20% of the speed of light, it would take between 20 and 30 years to complete the journey, and approximately 4 years for a return message from the Starship to Earth. According to Milner, the fleet would have about 1,000 spacecraft, and each one would be a very small, centimeter-sized vehicle weighing a few grams. He estimates the first fleet could launch by around 2036. Number 6. Ice-Free Arctic. The loss of Arctic sea ice is one of the clearest signs of human-caused climate. And so far, the Arctic Ocean has melted to its lowest extent ever recorded since satellites began measuring it in 1979. To make matters worse, the region's climate has seen temperatures increase at more than twice the rate of the rest of the world. This means that ice-free Arctic may happen much sooner than predicted so far. Sea ice is quite sensitive to temperature because it's so thin, and as temperatures warm, it gets thinner. The thinner the ice, the higher the chances that summer melt will be enough to remove the ice. So unless the global community drastically lowers emissions of greenhouse gases to keep global warming below the Paris Climate Agreement threshold, ice-free summers in the Arctic are going to become common during our lifetimes. An ice-free Arctic Ocean is often defined as having less than 1 million square kilometers of sea ice. And if this happens, it would dramatically affect global weather patterns and increase the magnitude and frequency of storms. The Arctic marine ecosystem would also be altered, with the added sunlight affecting the Arctic Ocean food web and melting the ice bed on which animals like polar bears and walrus hunt for food. Number 5. 99942, a Pappus asteroid threat. Before global warming brings humanity on the verge of extinction, a giant rock from outer space might wipe us all out. While you're watching this video, asteroid the size of a small mountain called 99942 a Pappus is hurling towards Earth through space, and there's a probability it will hit Earth on April 13, 2029. Discovered in June 2004, asteroid a Pappus is about 370 meters in diameter, and if it does make impact with our planet, its explosive power would create the most powerful earthquake on record. It is estimated that a Pappus would make atmospheric entry with 750 megatons of kinetic energy. For comparison's sake, the biggest hydrogen bomb ever exploded, the Tsar Bomba, was around 57 megatons, while the 1883 eruption of Krakatoa volcano was the equivalent of roughly 200 megatons. Using computer simulation, scientists have estimated that the hypothetical impact of a Pappus in countries such as Colombia and Venezuela, which are in the path of risk, could have more than 10 million casualties. However, the exact location of the impact would be known weeks or even months in advance, allowing any nearby inhabited areas to be completely evacuated and significantly decreasing the potential loss of life. However, if the asteroid hits Atlantic or Pacific oceans, it would produce a tsunami with a potential destructive of roughly 1,000 kilometers for most of North America, Brazil, and Africa, 3,000 kilometers for Japan, and 4,500 kilometers for Hawaii. Number 4. Chocolate extinction. Bad news for all of you chocolate lovers out there. Your favorite food may actually become extinct in a few decades. Cocoa plants are increasingly victims of fungal disease and climate change. And back in 2010, the spread of witch's broom, frosty pod, and other fungal disease have essentially destroyed cocoa trees in Central America, their original natural habitat. Scientists are worried that these fungal diseases could jump to other parts of the world and completely wipe out the precious chocolate-producing plant. The biggest problem is that cocoa plants are quite sensitive and need very specific conditions such as uniform temperatures, high humidity, abundant rain, nitrogen-rich soil, and protection from the wind. These conditions exist only in Côte d'Ivoire, Ghana, and Indonesia, which leaves the world's chocolate supply vulnerable to even small changes in climate. In fact, climate models predict by the year 2050, a 3.8 degree Fahrenheit or 2.1 centigrade increase in temperatures and drier conditions will occur in these areas and may further shrink the possible cocoa growing areas. These trends suggest that chocolate may actually become extinct unless something is done about climate change. But what if don't manage to reverse climate change? Can anything else be done to save chocolate? Well, Mars Inc. may have the solution. Not only has the company pledged to reduce its carbon emissions, it is also working with external scientists to develop genetically modified cocoa plants that can resist fungal diseases and live in a broader set of conditions. While the thought of eating GMO chocolate may be a bit scary for some people, it's still a better option than living in a world without any kind of chocolate. right? Number 3. Antibiotics stop working. According to a major 2016 UK study, urgent action is needed to control the use of antibiotics before they stop working and leave a number of major conditions untreatable. Resistance to antibiotics is growing at such an alarming rate that they risk losing effectiveness entirely, which means that medical procedures such as cesarean sections, joint replacements, and chemotherapy could soon become too dangerous to perform, and unless serious action is taken soon, drug-resistant infections will kill 10 million people a year by 2050. Drug-resistant infections are thought to be growing due to overuse of medicines such as antibiotic and antifungus treatments to treat minor conditions such as the common cold. With overuse, resistance to the drugs builds up and some conditions become incurable. Research has also suggested that antibiotic use in pig farming is common, as poor living conditions mean such treatment is necessary to prevent infections spreading between livestock, and that this passes down to humans through pork consumption, increasing resistance levels further. In the UK, 45% of all antibiotics are given to livestock. The study estimates that without action now, the cost of antibiotic failure will be $100 trillion between before 2050, and antimicrobial resistance might soon become a greater threat to mankind than cancer currently is. Number 2. Technological singularity. The technological singularity is the hypothesis that the invention of artificial superintelligence will trigger rampant technological growth, resulting in unimaginable changes to human civilization. According to this hypothesis, an upgradable intelligent agent, such as a computer running software-based artificial general intelligence, would enter a runaway reaction or self-improvement cycles with each new and more intelligent generation appearing more and more rapidly, causing an intelligence explosion and resulting in a powerful superintelligence that would ultimately surpass all human intelligence. In the 2010s, predominant public figures such as late English theoretical physicist Stephen Hawking expressed concerns that full artificial intelligence could result in human extinction. In March 2017 interview with the Times magazine, Hawking said that an AI apocalypse was impending and the creation of some form of world government would be necessary to control the technology. He also expressed his concern about the impact AI would have on middle-class jobs and even called for a complete ban on the development of AI agents for military use. In his book, The Singularity Is Near, American futurist and director of engineering at Google, Ray Kurzweil, predicts that by the year 2045, AI will have surpassed human beings as the smartest and most capable life forms on the planet, and machines will have attained equal legal status with organic humans, who may even become a minority on Earth. Number 1. New countries. Situations and circumstances keep changing, but conflicts rarely end. Unfortunately, in most cases, it is war that ultimately leads to the division of borders, and fights for independence have been ongoing for a long time in many parts of the world. As a result, the world may see the formation of new countries and borders in the near future. Over the next decade or so, a good number of regions may get the chance to go their own way and forge new states. While we can't say anything for sure, East and West Libya, unified Korea, the Shetlands, and Orkney, the United States of Europe, and Somaliland are five new countries most likely to emerge by 2026. Ever since Gaddafi was overthrown, Libya has veered between extreme visions of what it should be. Multiple self-declared governments emerged, each claiming to be the legitimate one. Amid all this chaos, East and West Libya have begun to pull apart from one another, and it looks extremely likely that they will split into separate states. While the idea of South Korea might one day reunify with North Korea seems like fantasy, it may not be as unlikely as you think. In fact, reunification is the official government policy in both North and South Korea. However, the cost of reunification would be enormous, and South Korea would have to pay $1 trillion to stop a reunified Korea from instantly collapsing. With a combined population of less than 70,000, the Scottish islands of the Shetlands, Orkney, and the Outer Hebrides might seem like the last places on Earth to fight for statehood. But with the threat of Scotland seceding from the UK, plans have been drawn up to potentially create three new microstates, or one federated collection of island states. The reasons for this is that many islanders feel more connection to Scandinavia than Scotland, and also tend to be much more pro-UK than Scots. As for the United States of Europe, many experts have warned that the EU simply can't continue to function in its current form, so either closer integration is needed, or a return to the days when the EU was merely a trading bloc. Given how interdependent many of mainland Europe's economies are, an even closer unification of European countries in the near future seems like a more plausible alternative. Finally, the self-declared state of Somaliland might become internationally recognized in the next few decades. Somaliland is one of three entities making up modern-day Somalia that declared its independence way back in 1991. In the 25 years since, it has run free elections, kept at peace, created its own currency, and developed economically. And yet not a single country has ever recognized its existence. Despite this, Somaliland has a strong claim to statehood. It does business with the US, EU, UN, and Arab League. It also has its own army and controls its borders. So it might not be long until Somaliland gets the recognition it seeks. Which of these events do you think is most likely to happen in your lifetime? Leave your comments below and subscribe to our channel right now for more incredible videos.